All right, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I'm here at the ModelOff 2013 Financial Modeling Championships, and I am honored to be here with Alex Gordon. Alex was the ModelOff champion from last year, and you know, Alex, I don't know if you've seen this on my podcast, but I'm very, very clear to point this next fact out whenever I have a chance. So you were the winner last year.
I was, yes.
World champion. And where did you find out about the competition?
I was wondering if you'd bring that up. I found out by a tweet that you sent out
there you go.
Last year. Yeah, so thank you very much.
That was a follow at Mr. Excel and a chance to win. What are the prices
could
this
take year? You around the world and win you $30,000.
$30,000.
How about that?
Wow, that's great. That's great. Alex, where are you from?
I'm from Wellington in New Zealand.
Wellington, New Zealand. All right. And what trick do you have for us today?
Just using spaces and formula.
Using spaces and formulas. Are you talking about the intersection operator?
Just your normal space, has a function as in a formula, but you can also just use it as you would in a sentence.
Really?
Just to space things out.
let's see what you mean.
Absolutely. So here I've got just a very basic calculation, two quantities, two prices, and we're going to calculate total revenue in one line.
Okay.
So the traditional way would just be first times second plus first times second, which is fine.
Sure. Right,
does what you need it to do. But as in a sentence, if you don't have any spaces in it, it makes it a little harder to read. So we can equally put a space after each of our arguments. So first times second, spacing, plus that times that. So the formula itself is identical. All we've done is put a space between every term.
Look at that.
And all it does is make it a little easier to read.
It's easier to read. Isn't that great?
And therefore, if you're the person building it, probably doesn't make a lot of difference. But if you have to hand it over to someone else, and you can imagine this has only got four bits in it. It's not
too difficult.
Right. But you do this with 10 arguments or a few nested functions, and it can really sort of help.
I will caution,
don't put a space before your first equals. Because, of course, that will start treating it like a text entry and won't evaluate.
But from then on,
you can put your spaces in.
That is a good tip. My mind is racing. Any downside here? Any danger that we're going to introduce any problems into the formula?
Not that I've come across.
Okay.
And I've picked this up from some model standards organizations, and nothing that I've come across so far.
So let's say that you had a function where you needed to do like the average, just in another cell, you wanted to do the average. Do you space inside the function parentheses or anything like that?
So there are some places you've got to be careful with it. So if I was going to do an average of these two, which isn't the most useful average,
right,
I'd do a space after my equals. But I won't do a space between my function and my bracket because that'll kill it. But once you've done your bracket, I mean, it's just a personal preference, I guess, at that point. If you want to make it nice and easy,
sure,
can put a space for in those two spaces.
Think, like with a VLOOKUP where you have four arguments or something like that, maybe a space after
that's
each comma.
A good one, yeah. Space after each comma makes it much easier to read.
That's cool. All right, Alex. Well, that is excellent. Now, of course, this will come out after the championship, so we'll know if you are the repeat winner.
Fingers crossed.
It's funny watching the other. There were 16 finalists last year. Four of those finalists are back, including Alex. And so the ones who know Alex are very upset that you're back.
Good.
Yeah, that's right.
It's great to see them all.
Very good. All right. Well, hey, Alex Gordon, good luck at ModelOff, and thanks for appearing on the podcast.
Thanks for having me.
All right.